The report was released by the School of Public Health at Makerere University on the impact of the loss of donor aid and its effect on health coverage in the districts of Kabarole, Kamwenje and Chenjojo. The three districts were being supported by Baylor and Murray Stops under the program Safe Mother Giving Life program.
Because Uganda is a low-income country, we depend a lot on external donors in our health sector. So this part of Uganda, of Rwenzori region, received support to reduce maternal deaths and newborn deaths. So before the Americans came in through USAID, in this region there were a lot of mothers who were losing lives trying to give life. We had newborns who were dying a lot. So now we got support in the form of a project called Saving Mothers Giving Life, where they strengthened our capacity to provide maternal care. So they upgraded the facilities, they built laboratories, they expanded the maternity wards.
The program included providing transport to pregnant mothers, visiting health centers for both delivery and antenatal visits, and recruiting health workers on top of government health workers. After the donors pulled out their services, the report indicates that there was a sharp increase in deaths of newborn babies between 2016 and 2017, registering a total of 160 deaths.
Although our data shows that overall that maternal deaths have reduced, doesn't mean that has reduced completely throughout the years we have looked at. There are some cases where actually they increased. We are worried from the data we saw that between 2016 and 2019 actually, the number of newborns in Kabarole district increased.
The medical officers, the midwives, those in charge of data management, they were all absorbed by the local government. The ambulance system that was started has been sustained.
The report also tackled maternal death, indicating that they declined in all three districts in the post-transition period, although with some fluctuations. However, in Kamwenje and Chenjojo districts, maternal deaths increased after 2020.
Ended the funding in 2016. They got funding from the Belgians, they got funding from the World Bank to continue the good work of USAID. So that's one thing, that they got a lot of this funding to continue supporting maternal care in this region.
Intensive care units. That was a new innovation all together. Before this Saving Mother Giving Life project, we did have any of these units in our facilities. But now, after treating them, we saw children that were very premature children, or babies, actually surviving. We could also see severely asphyxiated children also being put on care and recovering. Very, very.
Report by Jonan Tusingwire for the news.